Amen. Praise the Lord, my brothers and sisters. What a joy and a privilege it is to be with you this way. I thank God for you. I pray for you continually. My name is Minister Perry Kelly. I am an associate minister here at the Shiloh Baptist Church, Waukegan. And today I want to thank you for joining us as we continue our message series titled Stay True. Amen. A message about faithfulness. When we were together last time, we were continuing a theme, and we're going to continue this theme for this series, and that is that the Lord expects His people to remain faithful to Him. And so the last time we were together, we explored what it means to be faithful. We discovered that faithfulness involves the keeping of our word and the fulfilling of our responsibilities. We are faithful to God, and we should remain faithful to God because God is faithful to us. And so as we walk through Jeremiah chapter 35, we looked at the first 8 verses, and we saw that God lays out for us an example of how people, namely the Rechabites, refused Jeremiah's offer in the temple when he offered them wine to drink. You remember that, right? A people who by tradition practiced strict abstinence from strong drinks. In other words, they were faithful to their beliefs and their traditions. It was God's way of dramatizing the Israelites' unfaithfulness during the reign of Jehoiakim. And so today I want to pick up on our next point that we wanted to look at, and that is examples of unfaithfulness and also the consequences of unfaithfulness. And so in verse 12, it reads, "Then came the word of the Lord unto Jeremiah, saying, Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, go and tell them, the men of Judah, and receive the inhabitants of Jerusalem. Will you not receive instruction to hearken to my words, saith the Lord?" Amen. That's verse 12 and verse 13. And so in verse 12, we see that God speaks to his servant Jeremiah concerning what he had just witnessed. And so if we look at this verse, it said, "The word of the Lord came to Jeremiah." And I just wanted to point this out because this came to me as I was preparing this message. This was an everyday event. So when you walk with the Lord, you will hear from the Lord. Don't miss that. When you walk with the Lord, you will hear from the Lord. So when you ask yourself now, why haven't I heard from the Lord? You might want to ask yourself, am I walking with him? Am I near him so I can hear him? Amen. And so as the prophet acted step by step in obedience to the word of God, to the Lord's commands, God revealed more of his instructions and message to his spokesman. See, these verses make it clear that God was not advocating for the Rechabite lifestyle. Rather, he was spotlighting the Rechabites' commitment to their ancestor, a man, to contrast sharply with the utter disloyalty of God's people to their master. In other words, here's a people who honor and respect and obey the command of their ancestor, a simple man, and yet you Israelites who are called my people refuse to obey me. This is what unfaithfulness looks like: refusing to keep our word or refusing to fulfill our responsibilities. And so then it goes on in verse 13, and it says, The Lord of hosts, the God of Israel. Now watch this. The Lord of hosts emphasizes God's absolute sovereignty over all creation. And not only is he given the title of the Lord of hosts, but he's given the title of God of Israel. This signifies God's covenant relationship with his people. So when you take these two phrases, the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, when you take those two titles and put them together, they indicate that Jeremiah's oracle was an authentic and authoritative message for the men of Judea and the residents of Jerusalem, the Israelite people. And so what are we saying? God is speaking to his people. So what does God want his people to know? He wanted them to know that the Rechabites stayed true to a handed down tradition from their long deceased ancestor. But how much more now should God's covenant people attend to a fresh prophetic word from their sovereign Lord? So in verse 13, the Lord set forth a rhetorical question to his people. Will you not accept discipline by listening to my words? The emphasis on the phrase to accept discipline is to make or to take correction so as to learn a lesson. This is why God brings correction in our lives, so that we would what? Learn from it. Amen. So the Lord wanted to know if his people were willing to learn from the Rechabites' example. And so that's my question for you today. Are you willing now to learn from God's example? The word listening adds the element of acting on the lesson the Lord was trying to teach them. Sadly, however, the wording of the question indicates that the Lord knew his people would not respond as they should. And so the Lord continues to correct wrong behavior in his people, with the objective of his corrective acts still remains for them to learn about living a faithful and God-fearing life. And so then we get down to verse 14. Now comes the lesson. In verse 14, the words of Jonadab, the son of the Rechab, that he commanded his sons not to drink wine or perform, for unto this day they drink none, but obey their father's commandment. Notwithstanding, I have spoken unto you, rising early and speaking, but you hearken not unto me. God is giving us a glaring example of how people who are not believers can fulfill and obey their responsibilities, and yet those who are called by his name fail to be faithful in doing what it is that they have said that they would do, keeping their words and fulfilling their responsibility. God points out for us a stark contrast. The people of Judah spurned the Lord's commandments time and time again. They persisted in their disobedience. And so today God is asking his people, will you persist in your unfaithfulness? Because if you don't, there will be consequences. So when we get to verse 17 now, here it is. It says, therefore saith the Lord God of hosts, the God of Israel, behold, I will bring upon Judah and upon all the inhabitants of Jerusalem all the evil that I have pronounced against them. Here it is now. God pronounces judgment against unfaithfulness. Jeremiah declared to the people of Judah the consequences that had been decreed by a sovereign God. The phrase, I will certainly, is emphatic in the Hebrew, and it indicates that the opportunity for averting divine judgment had passed. Now it's too late. Because you did not hearken unto me, now these things will come upon you. So the citizens throughout the nation of Israel, and particularly the capital city, would suffer the disaster the Lord had pronounced. Although the details of God's judgment are not enumerated in verse 17, they are declared throughout the rest of chapter 34. Judah would fall, Jerusalem would be destroyed, and the devastated people would be taken into captivity. This is the consequence of unfaithfulness. I have called them, the Lord declared, but they would not answer. All the consequences would be a result of the people's stubborn unfaithfulness. My brothers and sisters, we are foolish to presume on the Lord's mercy and his patience. In his mercy, the Lord warns us of the consequences of unfaithfulness. In his patience, he gives us time and opportunity to repent. And so here we hear the words of Paul in Hebrews as he urged his Christian readers to encourage each other daily while it is still called day, so that none of you is hardened by sin's deception. And so, my brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you today to remain faithful to the Lord. He has given you everything you need to be used for his glory. He has blessed us with gifts and talents to bless others. You have been faithful over a few things. He's asking now, will you be faithful over all that I have given you? Have you been faithful with these things? Or have you been lazy in your love towards God and towards others? What stewardship has God entrusted to you? A husband, a wife, children, an opportunity to serve, a chance to share the gospel message? Remain faithful to that, my brothers and sisters. Stay true to what God has called you to do, because God is ever faithful to us. Amen. And so we're done for this time. And next time I want to wrap this series up with some good news. Amen. That there are rewards for your faithfulness. Until then, the Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance unto you and give you peace. Amen. Amen.